Welcome, everybody. We are here live at Geldwin Field. Just wrapped up a doubleheader. Great night of football. Week two, we're going to give you our wrap-up. I'm Sean Megger. Tim Brown is to my right. Mike Richmond is to my left. We're going to give you five games that stood out to us and five performances that stood out to us tonight. I think the game of the night for everybody, for me especially, was the real barn burner down there in South Salem. It was Thurston at South Salem. Thurston ends up winning that game 64-59. It was a rematch of a Week 2 game last year. South Salem beat Thurston last year, and when we went out and visited Thurston this year, it was really a game that Coach Justin Stark mentioned to us, and it was kind of their introduction to 6A. So a great game, back and forth both ways, 64-59 South Salem. South Salem now is 0-2, Thurston moves to 2-0.
All right, talking about another game, this one was my favorite of the night, going down to the Mid-Willamette Valley Conference, Corvallis playing Crescent Valley, and this is another one that came down to the wire. Corvallis down early, comes all the way back, and in the final seconds with 5 seconds to go, they kick a 43-yard field goal to go up 24-22 and win the game. This is an important game not only because Corvallis gets the win and moves to 1-1 after a tough loss to Marist last week, but also because it gives them the inside track to win the Mid-Willamette Valley Conference. All they have to do now is get past Lebanon and West Albany, and they should be good to go.
Another game of the night was actually one we saw here at Geldwin Field, Southridge and Lincoln in the first game of the doubleheader here tonight. It's a game that Lincoln had control of for most of the evening, and it gave the ball back to Southridge with 2 minutes left on the clock. Southridge drove down all the way inside the 20-yard line, and Coleman Vance, who played quarterback for most of the night for Lincoln, came up with a big interception. And Vance split time at quarterback with Johnny Williams. Williams played two drives for Lincoln. He threw two touchdown passes, including the game winner, with about 5 minutes to go. Southridge had a chance at the end, but just couldn't finish it out. Fourth game that we really looked at was Silverton and Woodburn. This game went to overtime. It was tied at 28 between both teams heading into overtime. Silverton got the ball first and scored, kicked the extra point to go up 35-28. Woodburn came down, five-play drive, scored a touchdown, decided to go for two in the win, and the Silverton Foxes came with a big stop on the 6-inch line and held on for the win 35-34.
And our fifth game is going to be two teams we're just going to kind of spotlight quickly. Two teams that did not have a lot of success last year, both went winless last year. Clackamas gets their first win in over a year, beating McKay 50-6, and Summit gets its first win in over 2 years, beating Benson 70-0. That'll kind of usher us into the performances of the night and pick out two guys from Summit. Brendan Brooks had two picks, both went for touchdowns and a receiving touchdown. And then sophomore running back J.T. Evans had four rushing touchdowns for Summit.
At the half, Tualatin leading Aloha 10-0, and Aloha's Thomas Tyner puts the Warriors on his back. He takes 36 carries for 295 yards in the game and gets the Warriors the win.
Another great performance came out of the Lake Ridge Pacers. This team's just been on fire offensively, and really it's been the duo, the quarterback Tommy Connect and the wide receiver Blake Dutton. Dutton had 5 TDs in week one. He had 3 TDs again tonight, all receiving touchdowns from Connect. That gives Dutton 8 on the year. Connect also has just been on fire at the quarterback position. These two look like a potent combo for the Lake Ridge Pacers.
Another player from West Linn. He was one of 4 players to throw a touchdown pass in that game, but Mason Finnerty, senior running back, he went for the hat trick tonight. He had a passing touchdown, a rushing touchdown, and a receiving touchdown, and the West Linn really cruises 55-14 over Centennial with 5 turnovers forced by the defense.
The last player in the spotlight tonight is Dallin Levitt. He's a transfer from Westview who plays for Central Catholic this year, and we got to see him in the second of the doubleheader. He had 2 interceptions that he returned for touchdowns, and he also had a punt return for a touchdown. And really, every time Levitt touched the ball, he looked like he was going to make something happen. He was almost breaking tackles, and he maybe had 2 other chances on special teams to get in the end zone. He looks like a really special kid for the Central Catholic Rams.
Well, that'll do it, folks. Wrapping up from Geldwin Field, those are our 5 games and 5 performances that stood out to us tonight. We will be back with you next week. We'll give you another video kind of looking at what we're going to look at in week 3. There's quite a few good matchups that we will highlight, and we'll be back. So check OregonLive.com tomorrow for all your scores, highlights, game stories, videos, and photos.